On our broadcast tonight, a denial from Philippine House Speaker Martin Romualdez that he instigated a people's initiative to amend the country's constitution. RG Cruz has tonight's top story.
Various progressive groups, including the Makabayan Bloc, picketed the gates of the House on the first session day of 2024 to voice their opposition to charter change. But Speaker Martin Romualdez was unfazed as he welcomed the Senate's decision to join the House in amending the restrictive economic provisions of the charter to allow foreign investors into more sectors of the economy.
We therefore welcome the recent move of the Senate, led by the Honorable Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri, in joining the House of its representatives in its historic and laudable efforts towards charter change via Constituent Assembly.
Former Speaker and Davao del Norte Representative Pantaleon Alvarez doesn't trust the charter change push now, warning it may be rushed and may go beyond the economic provisions. This even if Alvarez pushed for charter change under the Duterte administration as Speaker.
I cannot see the importance of changing the Constitution now. They say for economic reasons. Is it the people's interest or somebody else's interest?
Retired Supreme Court Senior Associate Justice Antonio Carpio is uncomfortable that the People's Initiative to allow joint voting of senators and congressmen in charter amendments continues even after the Senate agreed to amend the charter.
Binibigay na ng Senado yung hinihingi ng House, pero yung House tuloy pa rin mag-collect ng signatures. Binabaliwala yung offer ng Senado. Kung talagang sincere sila na economic provisions lang, pwede naman diretso sa economic provisions para walang mag-suspect na iba yung motibo nila.
Carpio, who penned the Supreme Court ruling striking down the People's Initiative during the Arroyo administration, maintained that this mode of charter change cannot be used to remove checks and balances.
Pwede yan for amendment of the Constitution lang, yung simple amendment lang. Pero pag pinapalitan mo yung check and balance, like yung separate voting, tatanggalin mo, gawin mong joint para overwhelmed na ang Senate, baliwala na yung boto ng Senate, hindi pwede yan kasi that is a structural change.
Senator Ronald De La Rosa tags the Speaker as the one behind the People's Initiative, citing unnamed House sources.
Yun ang sabi sa akin ng congressman eh. Yun ang sabi sa akin. Oh, hindi ko lang sabihin kung sino. Ang dami ng mababait na congressman sa Mindanao na nagpapasintabi, tatawag sa'yo. Pasensya ka na, Sen, ha? Following orders lang kami, mga ganon-ganon.
But the Speaker denied this.
Senator Bato talking, I don't know what he's talking about. He has not mentioned any comments. I don't respond.
De La Rosa claims those who signed in Davao received claim stubs worth certain sums of money.
Mga congressman, tanongin nyo kung sino congressman sa Davao, except Congressman Pulong and Congressman Ungab. Hindi sila kasama dyan.
Senate Majority Leader Joel Villanueva urges the public to report incidents of irregularities in signature buying. The Department of Interior and Local Government maintains nothing bars elected village officials from participating in the People's Initiative, contrary to statements attributed to DILG Undersecretary Felicito Valmusina. Former Congressman Alfredo Garbin already refuted Valmusina. The DILG explained that the Commission on Elections approved the recommendation not to prohibit elected village officials, but the agency warned them to just the same be careful till they are sure what they can and cannot do.
Ibig sabihin po pwede, but again, they cannot use government resources. No? Ganun po iyon, malinaw po iyan, maski saan. No? Pero po pwede. Po pwede po talaga yan. Let us proceed from this very carefully. As far as we are concerned, we wrote a letter.
Yung siguro binabanggit, yung tinatawag na non-partisan nature ng barangay election. Election po yon at nakalagay po yon sa kaso ng Quintos versus Comelec na sinasabi ng Korte Suprema na kaya nga sila namumulitika, therefore political ang barangay in SK election.
Election lawyer Romulo Macalintal urged the Comelec to stop accepting signature sheets till a petition is filed since the signatures cannot come before the initiative. But Comelec spokesperson John Rex Laudianco explained the signatures will be part of the petition that will be filed. Laudianco notes Comelec Resolution 10650 requires that the petition come with certifications that the required number of signatures have been met. The People's Initiative needs to gather the signatures of 3% of voters in each of the 254 congressional districts. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine senators met this evening to tackle proposed economic amendments to the 1987 Constitution. The caucus was called by Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri. A resolution of both houses that was meant to be referred to a subcommittee led by Senator Sonny Angara was instead referred to the Senate Committee on Constitutional Amendments chaired by Senator Robin Padilla. We will provide more details as soon as they become available.